So that was Pere Ubu on the Alternative Nation, and this is David Thomas, who was in Pere Ubu. And
is still in Pere Ubu.
Is still in Pere Ubu. So that's an ongoing concern, Pere Ubu.
Oh, yeah, we'll outlast everybody. It's the only thing we have left. You know, it's not like we're going to, you know, sell many records. So our one goal is like Khrushchev, you know, when he took his shoe off and was pounding on the table saying, "We will bury you." He wasn't saying, you know, that he would, you know, Russia would, by nuclear warfare, you know, eliminate capitalism. He's simply, you know, interestingly enough, saying that they would outlast capitalism, which, of course, ironically, they didn't. So that's our last ambition, is just bury everybody.
Right.
We've almost gotten there. There's not many people left from the 70s still producing music of any caliber. Most of them have dropped out, you know. So we're getting close.
Right, so you're still a long-term proposition as far as, oh, yeah. As Pere Ubu's.
Well, I mean, it was always, our role model was always, you know, Muddy Waters and Lightnin' Hopkins and all those people, and Picasso. You know, nobody said to Picasso, "You've got to stop. You know, you're 40 now. You know, good." You know, Picasso did his best stuff after he was 40. You know, I always wanted to be like Muddy Waters and have to be wheeled onto stage.
That doesn't mean you're going to become like John Lee Hooker and be doing beer commercials in 20 years' time, though.
I can't account for 20 years' time. It's too. I don't want to paint myself into a corner.
So, well, I mean, if that's the case, then, what are the immediate plans for Pere Ubu, if there are?
The immediate plans are always exactly the same plans. You write a new record, you make a new record, the record comes out, you go out on the road, you come home, you whimper and cry and swear you'll never do this again, and in 2 weeks you start the whole process over again, and you repeat that 20 times, and that's how you managed to survive to 1997. It's a fairly simple process. There's not a lot of, you know, not a lot of complexity to the whole thing.
Well, I'm joining a band tomorrow after that, I think, so.
Yeah, I would advise against it. Yeah.
Well, this is, we're going to now leap to you live.
Good.
Is there any kind of introduction you could give to that?
Well, we don't know what we're doing, and we'll do it well or not, and, no, let's, you know, let's let things speak for themselves, and now I will refer to you by looking at you, and you will refer to me, and we'll go back to staring straight ahead, and it'll be okay.
Great.
Where were the Gilbert and George?
It's a song about the human heart.
Thank you.
talk to you. Gotta be a matter of time. It starts you glad to be running some errand, and it's not a time to be walking alone. Oh, the times that you call me.
Check on time, please. Miss me.
just spread self-pity around. Yeah. It's a terrible thing to waste. It's a kids in the neighborhood, they see me walking down the street. They say, "There goes old man Thomas. There goes old Weezer." Yet. Let's do my favorite song, a song by Mr. Brian Wilson. I hate to spring that on you, Tex. Hit it, buddy.
Wherefore art thou? I'm filling time. Hit it, buddy.
A little surfer, a little water. Thank you. can ride the surf together. Song is about a roadside sign, 3 a.m. You're parked there, you hear an alarm clock going across the bayou. Why? Not a man, a bit of a cat. Tomorrow, better wind the clock. Tomorrow, better shut out the light. Tomorrow, better wake me up. Since she's gone. Somebody better fetch the beer. Somebody better come in out of the rain. I hear the sound of somebody leaving. It reminds me of the best old friend I ever had.
Welcome back to a treat-laden alternative measure. This is one of this evening's treats, David Thomas. So, a few minutes ago, you were talking with not a great deal of enthusiasm about the process of being in a band.
I'm entirely enthusiastic about it, but there's a certain amount of realism that we need to, you know, approach the subject with. And I'm all for it. This is, you know, it's the being able to withstand massive amounts of pain and endure oceans of tedium that, you know, that's the real enjoy of it. You know, this is the real. This is why ultimately, no matter what anybody says, you know, that rock music is essentially male. It has nothing to do with all those psychological things people blame on. It's because men are obsessive, you know, and can get into withstanding oceans of tedium where women usually have other things to, you know, do. But no, I you have to enjoy that. You have to. That's the brotherhood of it. That's the wonderful, you know. You spend you know 3 months out on the road living with the same four or five people, and then at the end of it, you go, see ya, you know, and you just go. So, sorry to interrupt.
You didn't. I don't think.
Okay.
I was about to apologize for the same thing. So this is Erewhon.
Oh yeah,
your record
with the price sticker still on it. I'm glad you guys bought that.
Yes, there you go.
$13.99. I think you paid too much, but that's
okay.
Oh
no, I think it was money well spent. What's it all about, David?
Well, it's about it's about places that don't exist and the people that live there. You know, increasingly culture is being reduced to a. You know, to pleasantly interactive push button lifestyle boutique choices, and you know it's you know there used to be a place called the Aeronautical Shot Peening Company on Old River Road, and it was all pastels, space cowboy facade, and it would shoot sonic fireworks into the night, you know, and you would go down there and you'd just listen to that, and it was something special. And they, a few years ago, they tore it down and built a puke palace in its place for kids to go drink cheap beer and throw up in the streets at 4 o'clock in the morning. Now, did they ask you if they could do that? Did they ask me? No. So what kind of a city, what kind of people, what kind of a world tears down the Aeronautical Shot Peening Company and puts up a puke palace in its place? Now, we just choose not to, you know, so how? What are you going to do? Are you going to, you know, you can't do anything about it. The culture is being co-opted and bulldozed. There's nothing you can do about it. You can't fight it. So a number of people, particularly of our generation, of the Pere Ubu group of people, have all reached the same conclusion that we simply refuse to acknowledge these things. So increasingly we discover that we live in a city that no longer exists. We live in a ghost town, and it's a better place. In our city, the Aeronautical Shot Peening Company still exists. In our city, Universal Vibration still exists, and this place still exists, and that place still exists, and it's a better city to live in. It gets only tricky when you have to go buy a loaf of bread from a shop that no longer exists. But these are, you know, tricks that you manage to learn. I think that's what it's about.
I think that seems to have summed it up nicely. I don't really know how to follow that, except I suppose we could go to Captain Beefheart.
Ice cream for crow.